On a song.
Eurovision.
Yes.
Oh dear. All right. Hello, everyone. Oh, welcome, welcome, welcome. So today we decided, or Carrie decided, I didn't really have much say, that we're doing a mystery box challenge today. So.
And by we, you mean tea.
By we.
Because one of us is going to buy the stuff. So.
Yes. So I don't know what's under here, which is going to be interesting. So we're going to see what's under here, and then we're going to figure out what we're going to cook, I guess. We may see some interesting inventions or experiments today.
Honestly,
I don't know.
Honestly, I had a couple of things in mind when I was putting this all together, which I think is generally what they do anyway. So I'm hoping that you do something that hasn't already been thought of by myself and by Spacey, who I put this to before putting it all together. So, I don't know, do we want to do a time limit?
I don't know.
Because I can't think of a way to... Oh, I guess we can chuck it on the oven, maybe.
What if I need to use the oven?
You may need to use the oven, that's true. We can... I don't know what we're going to do. But are you ready?
It's fine, here you go. Yeah.
Oh, you're going
to
do it?
Wait, am I going to do it? Do you want me to do it? Okay, alright, here we go.
Okay.
Okay, so we have our paper of staples here. So this is what I'm allowed to use. Flour, self-raising flour. I don't know what the difference is.
One of them is used more in baking and the other is used more in making sauces and
right,
things like
okay.
That.
Sugar, salt, pepper, milk, cream, butter, oil. Standard stuff.
We've also got white wine and eggs on there.
And eggs.
Yeah, not sure about the white wine, but I wanted to put it on the list anyway, so it's on our staples today. Okay, you ready?
Ready?
Go.
Ooh, interesting. Okay, what have we got?
So you've got a butternut pumpkin.
Ooh,
or squash.
Pumpkin.
Chicken stock.
Brown sugar. Chilies.
Yep.
Potatoes. Garlic. An onion.
Yeah, you can use more than one onion if you need to.
Chicken stock. And what have we here? What kind of meat is this?
It is a...
It doesn't say. You bought meat?
No, it does. No, what are you doing? Brisket.
Oh, beef brisket. Interesting. Oh, hey, look.
Has it got a marinade on already?
It says marinade.
Rip.
You bought one with marinade?
Oh, well.
Dan's game?
It's not supposed to have a marinade on it. Oh, well. We'll make it work.
Well, it says season to taste.
Maybe it's separate or something.
No, it says marinated.
Oh well.
Interesting. Well, if the marinade does have taste, then we'll find out. Okay, so let's get... Oh. God damn it.
You can move it all off. It was just because I didn't want to put, like, the...
Yes.
...stuff on there.
Okay. Pumpkin chili. Interesting. They are really good chilies. They're huge. Okay.
And you know what? This cost me 64 cents.
For three of them.
For three of them.
Wow.
Because it
Working
was like.
With 5-star ingredients here, guys.
Wait, is that a good thing or?
Yeah.
They're from Coles, alright?
Pretty easy for chilies.
Really?
Okay, I'll throw a dish. Let's figure out if it's marinated before we do anything with it. Doesn't seem marinated.
Maybe it's like in a separate packet or something.
Maybe. So I'm going to cut this dry.
Quite a bit of fat on that.
Huh?
Quite a bit of fat on that. So I will just warn people about this playlist. It is all of my songs that I have ever saved to Spotify, so there could be anything.
Oh, some nice bit of fat there.
I mean, it is brisket, so.
No, I've never actually cooked a brisket before, so.
Well, I mean, yes, you have.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what we were doing with the hot pot.
Oh, it's thinly shaved biscuit. Okay, so I don't have the boy coming. Okay. How does brisket turn out when it's handy? In case I need it. Let's do potatoes first, because potatoes are easy. I'm gonna do some good old baked potatoes. Which is all good. That then to figure out what the hell I'm gonna do with it. Okay, so potatoes. I'm gonna keep the skin on.
Alright then. Is that just because you don't feel like peeling them?
Because I like them.
Because it's nice. It's like nice skin.
Yeah, it's good skin. So much stuff here. Chips or halves?
Well, I did select you some potatoes that were a good size for chips in case you wanted to do that.
Yeah. Or I could half them first. Let's do this.
That's not really halved, but...
Half enough.
You're not very good at halving potatoes.
So half. Now, stick these on the tray. Nice and easy. And go for this. Oh.
What you doing?
I'm improvising. The theory is that if I poke it holes in, it will cook a bit quicker on the inside because of reasons.
Okay.
Okay, it's a root vegetable, so we need 200 degrees in the oven for these.
And remember, you don't have to use everything. You just have to use at least 3 ingredients, which it looks like you're quite willing to do. I mean, there's garlic.
Three ingredients is the garlic for sure.
You're going to use the garlic, so. Can't use olive oil. Has to be vegetable oil.
It has to be vegetable oil.
Yep.
Fine.
Okay. Olive oil has a taste. Sorry.
Well then. Well then. It's gonna make a quick thing to rub them in. Can I use both types of salt?
I would actually prefer if you just use the table salt and not the sea salt. Other way.
Table salt. Not
yep.
This.
We've just got some caveats with a bunch of these. So the salt and pepper, they have to be basically to taste or for seasoning. They can't be, you know, you can't do like a salt crusted
whatever. Salt crust.
You can't do, yeah, I know. And you can't like have actual pepper as like an ingredient in something. It's just got to be to taste. And then sort of similar thing with the oil, as I just said, it's got to be vegetable oil, not olive oil. Mm-hmm. The white wine can't be something you drink just for cooking. I don't know.
You can't tell me what to do. Well, actually,
skin them.
Oh, the tops of these, so they become a nice golden brown colour.
You know what's really good? Everyone from Australia can tune into MasterChef after this to watch to watch a lot of people do a mystery box challenge. Yeah.
Okay.
R.I.P. Not gonna get out of, get the what's his face out first?
What?
Or the goo?
No.
I'm gonna be impressed if you make pumpkin that I like.
We shall see, isn't it? We shall
yes.
see.
Doing some microwave ovens. Custom kitchen deliveries. We got to move.
The problem is that we only have one pair. Actually, that's a lie. We have another
pan. Do we? Oh, you're getting out the the electric frying pan, are you? Just to make sure.
It'll do the job
I just realized this is the explicit version.
Oh, is it?
Yeah. It should be over though. Got to move these color TVs.
Okay. I will get some butter for these.
Yes. Not the cooking butter. I'm gonna say you can use either, but I just assumed that you would prefer the cooking butter. Yes, we did. Play the guitar. Should have learned to play them drums.
I have no idea if this is gonna work, but if it does, I'm fucking gone.
All right. So we just got some butter in there.
Butter in there.
And we've got the potatoes in here.
So this is gonna be like, you know how you go to like Korean barbecue and you have like the pumpkin and stuff, it's gonna hopefully be the same thing, but with just like the sauteed grilled pumpkin kind of thing. There you go. So we're gonna see how this goes. If it doesn't work, we're having trouble. Okay.
Hey Spacky, if you want to come over and judge when it's all done, I'm assuming that you're here watching. That's not an onion.
I mean the garlic.
I have no idea.
They're growing.
Why are you getting so much garlic?
Because I want to make a pepper sauce.
Okay. A pepper sauce? How much pepper's going to be in that?
You said I can use pepper.
Yes, to taste, not as a main ingredient in something. I'll allow it, but just this time, and because I want it, I want to eat it.
It's gonna have like a sweet kind of pepper sauce, so this will be interesting. Okay.
You've got brown sugar. Yes, you've got sugar. Regular sugar.
So first things first, I need to get the fat off this because I don't have any beef flavor right now. So cut half of this.
So it should be a nice tender cut as well.
So I'm gonna cut. My butchery skills are pretty bad. So.
That's another thing that we want to try and do at some point is learn how to break down some things
like a chicken,
like filleting a fish and breaking down a chicken. Anyone would think that we're planning to apply for Masterchef. We're not, at least not yet.
No, we're not.
So are you going to use this to get some beef flavour into the pan? And
that's the idea.
Okay. So you're making the sauce before you make the beef itself.
Yes, beef doesn't take a long time to cook.
Okay.
If I pan fry it. It looks like I can, I can braise it as well. I don't want to braise it.
Well, you got white wine, you got chicken stock. Thing's not working again, so that smells so good, but I think it just smells so good because it's butter. Alright, I'm gonna check the stuff. Inari's come here from Doom Wipes, and Spacky is not in the channel. If someone could contact Spacky and tell her that Merf the Chef is on, that would be great. Although she should know better.
Oh, this beautiful fat on the bone is so flavorful. What was that? Who was that?
It's Inari telling Spacky that Merf the Chef is on. We can hear you, Inari. Thank you.
Okay.
What is this?
What is what? This song?
Yes.
I don't know, it's your playlist.
I know. It sounds like shiny.
Yeah.
Oh, it's Lucky Star. Okay.
I'm gonna mix this in with my oil here.
Alright.
A little salt mixture thing.
Smells so good, man. I know, but it's butter.
Butter always smells good.
I swear, if I was doing MasterChef in a mystery box challenge, I'd probably just put some butter on next to my thing, no matter what I was doing. They'd come over and be like, that smells good. I'll be like, that's the butter. It's what it is. Do I know what? Looking pensive.
No, that's not too much.
What were you going to do?
Just going to do a pumpkin puree, maybe. Let's get the sauce. Sauce is most important. Get some of this.
I like how I got you out just a really nice garlic and you're not even using it. It's like, because we're going to use this same beautiful looking garlic for every single...
So, for every single...
Merf the Chef challenge.
Total. Exactly what.
So, next week, provided this goes fairly well, Merf will be mystery boxing for me. So...
Interesting.
Look forward to that.
Do you want to take a shot of this fat? Fat covered in oil and salt.
So tasty.
Yeah.
So, how much of this did you see beforehand?
None. Absolutely zero.
No, that's good.
I saw the beef in the fridge when you were storing it, but I didn't actually know what kind of beef it was. So.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, it looks
like
you need a little...
I'm going to make a garlic white wine.
Mmm.
Usually it goes with chicken, but I think I'm going to make a brown garlic sauce. Tasty.
You know what's really good? Now I can smell garlic and butter. Very tasty.
So we're gonna amp the garliciness of the sauce up like crazy. Because you can never have too much garlic.
So the real struggle I had with getting ingredients is that there's so many spices that I want to cook with that I can't.
It's good to limit yourself sometimes.
Yeah. I mean, you're always going to find something when you have salt and pepper, though. So.
Salt and pepper, absolute staples. Cannot live without salt and pepper.
That's sort of why we, like, it didn't look like they had salt and pepper in any of the staples stuff that I saw. So I just, I added it because I don't want to cook without salt and pepper. Ever. Actually, I could probably go without pepper, but not salt. And we were considering adding soy sauce to our staples because we're Asian, and that's just... I'm not Asian, but we cook Asian food a lot. So the other thing that I considered that you might want to do is actually sort of slice up that beef and garlic, chili it. Sear it all off. I'm sure you will. And like you said that was expensive, but like 64 cents.
Okay. So
I don't
think that should be enough.
Okay.
Inspiration from K barbecue. Right? So I'm gonna as much of this fatty nuts.
In case you can't hear, he's taking inspiration from K barbecue and removing fattiness.
Well, not removing fattiness. This is a nice fat, yeah.
Yeah.
But this is, we're gonna do like a thinly sliced beef. Like that. So it's kind of like you know how like you have pay barbecue meat that you put on the grill, and you have like Japanese sashimi. This is like a similar thing.
Does your knife need sharpening?
No. It's a little one in the middle.
You know what? I actually really want to just eat it.
You can eat it like this.
There's a little bit more chat, so I'm gonna check that out.
What?
Anari was just laughing at my, we're Asian, I'm not Asian. and Kipcha says, if you can still taste the food, you haven't added enough garlic.
That is true. Garlic makes the world go round.
It also protects from vampire attacks.
Yes.
Nobody wants to be attacked by a vampire. Almost nobody wants to be attacked by a vampire. I know some people who would embrace that.
This is a feeding back here, so I'm going to chunk this in. Put it in there.
So what are you planning to do with these onions?
They're going to go in the sauce.
Okay. Trying to think of something like to say that like George or Gary would come around and tell you to stop doing.
Just like, you know, try and pull me off my game.
Yeah. I can't think of anything.
Are you sure you want to do this? Is this really what you want to do? This is not a very nice piece you need to work on.
It is or it isn't?
It isn't. I'm not always. It doesn't seem to get all that much flavor. Yeah, this is not a very good piece. So I'm going to use this to get more beef flavor in the stock for the sauce.
The thing is, there's no bone. So
that's why I need more fat and more meat.
Are you gonna grab some more of this one then?
Yes.
Okay.
But that's not really a meal.
No, that's not really a meal.
Oh,
that actually looks really good.
Rendering on it. Back down. And smell that meatiness.
Smells so good, guys. How's your pumpkin doing?
Let's go check it out.
Is it on? Oh yeah, it'll like go on and off to maintain temperature.
So if you love me.
You know I'm here waiting for you, I'm just across that. You seem to be struggling a little bit with that. And if you leave here, you leave me broken, shattered, alive. I'm just across that. I'm just a shot, though we could die. That is a lot of butter.
Yeah, this is going to be a very rich sauce. This is the idea.
So it's all about the sauce and not so much about the meat. Just going to do
meat complements the sauce.
Yes. You're going to do a very rich sauce and a not as rich meat. That's just very simple.
No, the meat will be cooked to perfection.
Absolutely.
Are you sure that's a good choice?
Yes, I'm sure it's a good choice. Of course it's a fucking good choice. I'm cooking.
I'm glad that you didn't put all of that in straight at once, because I knew that you'd want to put some more in later.
Yes,
correct. R.I.P.
This is totally good.
So good. Not so good. Or you could use it on the pumpkin.
I could use it on the pumpkin. But pumpkin's already inherently sweet, that's a problem. So I don't wanna make it too sweet.
Very tender. It's like the
it's like
pork belly, yeah. Of the meat world, of the beef world, sorry. It's really wanting to play shiny today.
Yeah. Oh, no.
I mean, you could probably just do that with all of them, to be honest. So good, man. Notice you're getting thicker and thicker, though. Mm. That's what she said.
Whoa!
What?
Terrible.
Oh my god, I'm sorry. You know, eventually we'll have a real camera.
Yeah, eventually. We'll have it stationed up.
So that I don't have to hold it. Seems to have reduced down a little bit.
I'm curious, yeah.
just want to always
slicing this
beef. Super nice pieces.
I'm gonna get so no one ever done no good. No, you more than go to the need bargain so. So, such and so nigga, so oh, I'm so curious, yeah. So that looks a little bit more filling. This also looks filling, though.
You can braise that later. You can actually add more ingredients to work with.
Okay.
Salt this.
This is epic sex guy song.
Yeah. It's amazing.
Go Moldova. Did we give them 12 points with our public vote?
Yes, we did.
We are amazing.
We always give the troll one.
Well, I mean, I'm not sure how much of a troll one toy was this year, but we did give them 12 points. I was really surprised at where the Czech Republic was for Australia's public vote, though. They, like, got 3 points from us or something. I would have thought 10. So if you're salting meat, you should either do it right before you put it in the heat, or you should do it a little bit before.
Yeah, about like a 15-20 minutes before. Because what it does is, you can see here already, look, I don't know if you can see with the camera, but if you put salt on meat, salt draws moisture out. So you can sort of see like it's glistening, it's drawing the moisture out. But if you leave it for long enough, the process of osmosis occurs and it draws that salt back in, so they'll flavour the meat quite nicely, which is what I want.
Yes.
Yeah.
So now would be the very worst time to put it onto heat.
Correct. Because all that juicy goodness will be gone. Alright. I want to make a chili jam.
You want a what?
A chili jam.
Smells so good. Hopefully. I can't imagine it not tasting good though. So I think Merf's gonna actually manage to use every single ingredient in the mystery box challenge. Alright, I'm checking the comments. Did we give you a time limit?
No. What's the time now?
It is nearly 6 o'clock.
Nearly 6 o'clock?
Yep. When did we start?
We're ready. We start at 20 past.
20 minutes remaining.
22 minutes remaining. Sparky, do you want to come over and help me judge? Remember, you've got a plate as well.
Yes. So, chicken stock.
Yeah. That's why I got two of them yesterday. Yep. We put white wine on the staples list because I wanted it on there. All right.
I'm sure I've already tasted this. Seems sweet.
It's a Sauv Blanc.
Oh, you have the sweet wine.
It's not that sweet. It's not like I got a Moscato or a, even an SSB. I just got a cheap white wine. Would you prefer a Chardonnay next time? Yeah. I don't like Chardonnay, so.
It's not for drinking, though. It's for cooking.
Yeah, but I don't like Chardonnay. It's like oaky and weird. I'll just ask them for a dry, bitter white that isn't a Chardonnay.
Okay, so. I'm gonna have a caramel.
What are you making?
Caramel.
Caramel.
Just add your sweetness. There's no sweetness in this dish.
Yes.
Richness, but no sweetness. No.
Also, to be fair, Spacey, if he doesn't finish this in an hour, I'm going to let him keep going. Because I would like to eat something tasty for dinner. But on the plus side, he hasn't done a roast, and he also hasn't done pumpkin soup, so...
I think normally white sugar is used to make.
You can use it.
I like this.
You can use white sugar. It's on your staples list. You don't have to use the brown sugar.
Just add a bit of heat as well to the dish, which is nice.
We do like garlic, don't we?
Yeah, I can actually...
Why did you do that?
I don't know.
Good job. Yeah, I'm checking the things again. Okay. Oh, okay. Nine Fingers says, are you two dating?
I don't know. I don't know if we're dating. We're engaged. Does that count? We're getting married in a year. Just under a year now. Holy shit. We should actually probably organize our wedding and shit, eh?
Yeah.
Like.
Yeah, that might be a good idea.
Like, that's...
I think that's a good idea.
That's generally what you do, right?
Organize, yeah, you do generally organize the wedding.
Oh, this chili smells really good.
It shouldn't be too bad, like, I didn't get bird's eye ones.
I feel like I need to mince this a bit more. I'm just feeling.
Also, both Dan and Spacey have arrived now, so. We've got the whole Senate here.
The whole Senate. This is just chili garlic.
You know, it'd be really nice. If the chat came up.
Yeah, that would be nice.
On the phone, that would be really good. Well, you've got 16 minutes. Remember how to make caramel.
Yes.
Very good. Well, that was quick.
Yeah.
You got it very hot.
This is pretty hot for the beginning.
Hope it doesn't burn before it dissolves.
Apologies for that. I'm going to go over here because I need to make sure this doesn't go off again. Good job. Do you want a darker caramel though?
Yeah, it's fine. Can I add some water to stop the process? It's going to stop the caramelization process. I learned that.
Yes. Yes, you did. It's like the opposite of chocolate.
Yeah.
You like add water to make it caramel.
Add some chili and garlic in.
We're almost making something that's like satay.
Yeah, no, almost.
Smell that? Oh my god, that's potent.
You're not gonna eat much of this, that's for sure.
Look at him, he's a good boy. He's cleaning up as he goes.
I actually have to, I need it for later, so. Alright. Mango bits.
Twelve minutes remaining. Potatoes. Oh, steaming up. No, we don't want that.
What?
Steaming up. We don't want that. Hmm? All right, while you do that, there was a lot of excitement in the chat, I noticed.
Okay.
Oh, you know what? This is interesting because I can see chat on the screen thing sometimes, but not all the time. But it's behind the other chat that doesn't work. So I'm just going to pop that here for a moment.
Okay.
Okay, Chris, I was saying satay, which is Vietnamese chili, garlic, oil, fish sauce stuff. And yes, it does sound like satay, but it's satay. There. Ten minutes remaining.
That's all I need to cook.
Okay. More like a consommé.
Where's my flour?
Don't make to get it for you.
Can you give me corn flour? Am I allowed corn flour?
No.
Give me normal flour. Thank you.
I would just like to say it does say plain flour and self-raising flour. It does not say corn flour.
Okay.
You don't a bitch! Be my girl! I would recommend making it into a paste with water first. That's a lot of water.
Make a slurry. What I'm doing.
This is how you thicken sauce.
Yeah. In a pinch. Yeah. I actually did this the wrong way. I should have made a roux first before I put it in, but it's a bit too late now.
Too late. Get the spoon. R.I.P. R.I.P. sauce.
Yeah, I have the chili jam, that's all good. Now I need... this plate. This. Thank you.
smells so good, man.
Pretty good cut of meat, that's why it doesn't really need much help.
Are you just saying that because,
No, I'm saying it's pretty good. It's pretty good. My plants are pretty good.
Might need to trim the fat from some of those.
Fat will render down.
One of these is not done. Can I turn that off? Wow, that was worthwhile. R.I.P.
Unfortunate, but yeah, we've got a chili. Time is
1 minute.
1 minute to go.
Can he plate up in time, guys?
I don't think I can, right?
Just do one plate in time.
Thank you. Yeah, it is.
That might just be because of the cut. The ground is really spicy. What's this?
It's rare.
What did you intend for this to be cooked at?
Medium rare. Oh my, that sauce is so good. Very sweet, but I think it goes well. Mm. Let's try with the potato. What I would have done different is I probably would have thought that after I put the potatoes in is make like a potato gratin, is that how you say it? And the thinly sliced potatoes stacked on top of each other, that would have been. And I think the potatoes needed butter. Some butter on these potatoes. Butter makes the world go round. Look at that glistening. The success, I think, of this dish is this chili.
Something new.
It came out exactly how I wanted it. Sweet and with a bit of kick. It's not the worst thing I've put.
No, I feel like that honour is still held by those profiteroles you were.
That was amazing.
I don't think amazing would be the word I would use.
Put you
in the top three for Masterchef. No,
it would not.
It might get you out of the bottom three.
I don't know. I would say this
is the bottom three good for me. But like, given the lack of spices and things.
I guess so.
Not that it matters when you're screwed up to town. I actually like this a lot with the potato.
Yeah? Pretty good.
And playlist is enjoying its shiny songs tonight.
Oh, you K-pop.
Yeah, but like...
Oh. That's actually jam on the potato. Holy shit. Oh, so good. You know what kind of reminds me of? You know, like the... At the time, I can get like the potato swirly stuff things. You can get like the sweet topping on it.
I don't think I ever would have put sweet on mine, so I don't really know. Yeah. You know me.
Yes.
I would be like, yes, give me whatever you have that is parmesan and cheese and salt.
I think it is. Now, the only thing we need to do for this social eating stream is actually have a visible chat so you can talk with people. Hopefully we'll have some soon. Guys, so we'll have a tablet of some sort that we can actually connect to chat and actually be able to interact with you guys while we're doing this. But yeah. Have you told them about our project that we're doing?
I have not.
No. Oh. So we are going to be blogging now. We're going to become a food legit blog.
Legit.
So all the recipes from the streams, and also while we're not streaming, we're posting up on there. Until we get a few more things, we'll get a proper domain name and everything. But for now, it's merfthechef.wordpress.com. This is a free domain. For now. And yeah. And episodes of Merf the Chef will go up there, as well as recipes and all that jazz.
At the moment, there is a recipe for leftovers hot pot.
Leftovers hot pot. Definitely try that one. Really good.
And should be having a pumpkin soup one up there either today or tomorrow.
Yeah. So check it out.
Since some people have never had pumpkin soup before.
I thought pumpkin was like a big thing in America. How did it work?
Maybe they just use it for their coffees and things. They don't use it for
actual food. Yeah. Who knows? So check it out. Subscribe, follow, like, etc. And thanks for watching. We're gonna finish dinner, do all the cleanup, and we'll back at some point. Are we gonna do a midweek one? I don't know. We might do a midweek one. We might just come back next week. Next week will be a special because we have people over. There won't be a mystery box.
You have
to midweek mystery box.
You can just get it on the way home from work.
I could. Very limited though. Alright, thanks for watching, guys. We'll catch you later. Bye bye. I'm gonna manhandle you guys for a bit while I turn this off.
There we go. And stop.